asking right now, why is Oklahoma throwing the football? This big of a lead, 7:21 the clock, is because this young man's a freshman. And if he's going to be on the field, he needs to run their offense in order to gain experience. And Mike Leach understands that on the other side of the field. This isn't trying to run anything up. And that one, what he's going to learn there is sometimes, and Nate Hibble's telling him, you got to take a little bit off your fastball.
That's right. He had a little velocity.
I mean, he had a little velocity on it. Brandon Jones couldn't come up with it. Ball tipped in the air. Ricky Saylor, his second interception of the game.
And that's Paul Thompson's first collegiate interception. There was 7:21 to go. Trailing 53-15, Texas Tech on the offense. Being chased again, and Kingsbury again is going to have to dump it off. Dan Cody putting the pressure from behind. Dan Cody, the sophomore out of Ada, Oklahoma, just south of Norman. He's been the surprise on this team. Didn't play in the A&M game, had some problem with a concussion, finally got cleared late this week to play in tonight's game.
And boy, was he happy to get cleared. What a night that he's had. You know, wreaking havoc in the backfield of Texas Tech. But how many times have you noticed against a good defense, when you run a trick play and you're successful and you come back with another one, you're very unsuccessful? Mm-hmm. Once you've shown a trick play, now everybody's kind of got their defenses up. And Oklahoma really is too good to be fooled very often by trick plays.
Second and 10, they bring five. Pocket collapses and Kingsbury goes down again. Dan Cody with his second sack of the night, joined by Lynn Magruder, the sophomore out of Las Vegas. Six sacks on the night for this OU defense.
And right now, if you're Mike Leach, you know what else is running through your head? At one point, do I pull Cliff Kingsbury and not get him hurt?
Yeah.
You know, before a bowl game, he's had a terrific career. And that play, I believe, it looked like number 90, Eric Hilaire, in the sack. I mean, between 80 and 90 is tough to tell sometimes, but I think Eric Hilaire ended up getting the sack on that one.
Another senior play out of Oklahoma City. Pass incomplete on third down and 12. Intended for Torian Henderson. Texas Tech, I think, will be forced to kick it, but nobody's moving to come out the kick.
Yeah, I'm not sure what Mike Leach is going to decide to do here. It looks like he's going to go ahead and go for it. I mean, feeling they have nothing left to lose at this point. But you mentioned Hilaire. He's a walk-on.
Yeah.
He's now getting to play. Another example of the old adage, those who stay in a program will eventually play.
Mm-hmm.
And Eric Hilaire got his chance as a senior and has made the most of it.
Well, Tech tried one other time on fourth down, didn't get it. Two to snap it. One to snap it. He's not going to get it off. Finally, the official blows the whistle. They're going to go back five more yards, and it'll make it fourth and 17.
5 yard penalty.
When you're down 53-15, sometimes that urgency doesn't quite creep in. You saw how long it took them to go over and get the play call.
Mm-hmm.
And then it wasn't as if Cliff and the offense just dashed back out to try and get it off, because ordinarily he's sharp and focused and in the ball game. Talk about Cliff Kingsbury.
Right.
It's been such a tough night. It dulls your edge a little bit, and he wasn't conscious of the play clock. It ran out on. Now it's fourth and 15.
Straight drop pressure coming. Throwing deep down the sideline, and the Sooners will take over. 6:24 to play in the ball game, and this OU offense, OU defense, stands up to the challenge again. You can only sense his frustration, and it's tough because they have been operating on all cylinders lately, but the bubble's been burst tonight. Now, just a reminder, we don't want you to miss the drama of the PGA Grand Slam of Golf on TNT. Tiger Woods, he's won it four times, takes on Rich Beam, Justin Leonard, and Davis Love III. Catch all the action starting on Tuesday, November 26th, only on TNT.
Now, what's this about EJ and Charles going to Hawaii?
Yeah.
Going to do their show from Hawaii?
Yeah. They're going to Hawaii. Bobby Clampett will be there. Billy Cratchit will be there. And Ernie will be there. Pass complete to the 20-yard line. Paul Thompson gets it over to Brandon Jones, the sophomore out of Texarkana, Texas, also the Oklahoma center fielder on their baseball team. Very talented young man, drafted by the Yankees. Must be nice to have that choice. Let's see. OU football, national championships,
New York
World
Yankees.
Series.
Two pretty good programs, huh?
That's right. Two good programs, good recruiting. Here's our bowl results. How many Big 12 teams will go to the bowl games this season? Well, 6, 48%, 8, 44% of you, and 8% said 10. How about 9? Keep it on the ground inside the 15, down to the 13-yard line. Ronaldo works. Well, here's the bowl arrangements. The BCS, of course, will be the national championship. The Cotton Bowl will get the number 2 team in the Big 12. Holiday Alamo Bowl. Derek Fox is a great bowl down in San Antonio. Pesky Hill and the guys. Tom Starr, Independence Bowl, great bowl game. Of course, you also throw in the Houston, the Tangerine, and the Humanitarian Bowl in there.
And don't be surprised if some of the other conferences that don't fill their bowl slots, that there's not another one that a Big 12 team doesn't appear in. Because you know they're going to negotiate hard to make sure all 9 teams that are eligible have a chance to go play in the postseason.
There's our first look at Gerard Estes, the junior out of Wichita Falls, Texas, only his 9th rush of the year. 6'1", 185-pound junior. So Coach Stoops putting in a second team line, and you see Lamont Anderson, the player injured on the play. Now, one of the big games, Washington, Washington State, with an update. Here's our Ernie Johnson.
There, Ron, and things have tightened up considerably in that game. You saw the score was 20-10. That's when Cody Pickett hit Paul Arnold to make it 20-17. Now, Jason Gesser of Washington State hurt his right leg. It's his right shin. He needs to be x-rayed. He's out. His sub, Matt Kegel, throws the pick to Nate Robinson. Washington in position late in the game to tie things up. And they turn to John Anderson. And suddenly that game is Barbara Walters, 20-20. They're going to overtime.
Somebody call Hugh Downs. I can see that court score clearly, Ernie.
You know, when you're getting ready to get on a plane and go to Hawaii, all of a sudden you can joke about everything, can't you?
You know? You can.
Just like our man Corey up here.
That's right. You know. By the way, we have a moment. We want to thank our entire crew, everybody in the truck, our producer Scott Cockrell, our director Lonnie Dale, Bert Bondi, Maceo Grant, Jeremy Levin. Thank you, everybody at Turner. You've made this year. This is our last game. Kevin Weiberg of the Big 12, Tim Allen, Bo Carter, all our friends at the Pac-10. Thank you, and a special thank to Sam Polis up here in the booth with us. Been with me for about 7-8 years now. Makes us look good every week. Thank you, my friends. We appreciate all your help this year. Is complete inside the 10, down to the 6-yard line. And the fans, Chester on the reception.
And Chris Chester, his second catch of the year. His first one came in the Missouri game. Many people remember that on the fake field goal. Matt McCoy hit him at a time that it looked like Oklahoma was really struggling in the game, and they faked it and got it. That was the only catch Chester had up until this point.
He's a big one. Now the fans on fourth down saying just go for it, and Bob Stoops will probably run the football.
Yeah, run it inside, and see if you get it, great, and if you don't, so be it.
Yep.
I mean, there is a nice code among the coaches for some sportsmanship.
Well, some of the coaches wanted a timeout. No, Thompson's going to throw it, puts it up, end zone, touchdown, Oklahoma, Brandon Jones.
Based on my comments, people could say, as we take a look here at Paul Thompson throwing the touchdown pass, nice in move by Brandon Jones, moving back out to the pylon, an excellent catch. And you see Bob Stoops happy to see good execution. A lot of people would think that what I was saying was if he didn't run the ball, it wouldn't be good sportsmanship. That's not the case at all.
Yeah.
It's just right now, I go back to what I said before. You got a young kid in the game. You got to get him experience. It's not a matter of running it up. It's a matter of him getting game experience in situations he'll have to play throughout his career. And Oklahoma is truly rolling.
Something to cheer about is Oklahoma leading.